Ahoy! I'm Jeffrey Weil, the rabbi of this congregation, Ezra-Habonim, the Niles Township Jewish congregation. And welcome to Megillahgan's Islands, our 12th annual Purim Shpiel. You know, it takes all hands on deck to make for a successful Shpiel. And so some thank yous. Thank you to our sponsors. Your generosity has allowed this to happen and supported our congregation and our programs as well. So thank you so much to you. Thank you to our cast and crew, working under very different circumstances this year, sharing your talents with us. We can't wait to see what you have produced. Thank you, of course, to Kenny Dermer, the man in red, whose genius and commitment and tireless work has allowed this to happen once again for us. And mostly, friends, just thank you. Thank you, all of you, for allowing us to broadcast the Megillahgan's Islands to you today. I watched Megillahgan's Island as a kid. I watched it quite a lot. Funny show. What, a half-hour program each week? 20 minutes because of commercials, maybe? Honestly, we do way more programming than that here at Ezra-Habonim, the Niles Township Jewish Congregation. Half hour, we do hours and hours of programs each week. Educational, religious, social, cultural. Check us out. Check out EHNT.org to see everything that we're doing, and please join us. Megillahgan's Island was a funny show. I liked it a lot. Fun fact, Tina Louise, who played the auburn-haired starlet Ginger, a Jew. Natalie Schaefer, who played Mrs. Howell, a Jew. There are funny Jews out there. I've heard that there are funny Jews out there. Some of my favorite funny Jews, Mel Brooks, Carl Reiner, Jerry Lewis, Sarah Silverman, there's Seinfeld. There are a few more funny Jews. But the funniest of them all, the prototype of the funny, funny Jew is, of course, Mordechai. Let's find out how funny Mordechai actually is. Sit back, everyone. Relax. Turn off your phones. You don't want to be interrupted during this program. And let's all enjoy Megillahgan's Islands. Thank you.
Just sit right down and you'll hear a shpiel like you've never heard. That started with an overture before we said a word. This day is an average winter night. You're stuck in your room. Our thespians will sing for you in a 1 hour Zoom. A half hour Zoom. The story hasn't changed at all. A dozen years we've tried. If not for the courage of our Esther, true, all Hebrews would have died. All Hebrews would have died. We launch our story off to sea, abroad it cruises the sea, with Mordechai and Esther too. Ahasuerus, his first wife. Amos here.
That was a great final rehearsal. This is going to be the best Purim cruise in history. Okay, everybody, grab your seats, but be far apart. You are way too smelly and sweaty to be sitting close. Chas Nolan. Hey, thank you for a wonderful Big Ten performance, and thank you for doing the Teresh half the song. Hey, where's Wilson today?
He wasn't feeling well this afternoon, so I told him to stay in the cabin. We have practiced that number together so many times that we could both do it in our sleep. Besides, I know you'd want him to be as healthy and fresh as possible for our show tomorrow night.
Oh, please. Wilson's ego's overinflated. He's a blowhard full of nothing but hot air.
Mr. Robinson Caruso, you are not Haman right now. Don't be so angry about everything. We're tight-knit like relatives. We function like multi-tools working together to build a great show. We're a Swiss Army knife family. Robinson?
Sorry, not.
Okay, everyone, here's the schedule for Erev Purim and Purim. Dinner starts at 5:30. so the Jewish cast members can hear the rabbi read the Megillah at 7 p.m. right here in the Lido Deck Theater. I understand our Esther, our Julie, will be opening for him. Now I need everyone to get a good night's sleep. We'll have a light rehearsal and a late lunch so that we're not performing on a full stomach. After the show, we'll have a great cast party banquet. You can eat to your heart's content. All right, cast call tomorrow 6:30, curtain up at 8 p.m. sharp, come hell or high water. Now, you know my philosophy. If you're on time, you're late. All right, any questions?
Are you sure we're ready?
Ready? This is my 12th Purim cruise that I've written and directed the Spiel. And this is by far the best cast ever. Watching you tonight makes me sure that each and every one of you could do your parts regardless of hearing or seeing the other actors. Your timing is perfect.
Why, thank you. I'm not worried about it either.
First, I want to say, these chairs are super comfortable. And second, thank you, Megillahgan, for bringing us all together for the show aboard this tiny ship. How do you come up with all these wonderful songs and scripts?
I think of old music in my brain, a peppy tune with a catchy refrain, the kind that makes you want to sing along. I like my Purim Shpiel and songs, maybe a number from old Broadway. A lot of dancing makes you happy and gay. I change the words to move the story along. I like my Purim Shpiel and songs. I like the Purim Shpiel and songs. The melody's right, the words are all wrong. It don't matter, they don't last too long. Not for my Purim Shpiel and songs. They'll make you laugh or they'll bring you to tears. Don't use no music for the last 30 years. Don't watch a Barris to give me the gong. Not for my Purim Shpiel and songs. And what I relish, what gives me a thrill, is watching people of their own free will. They don't feel they need to smoke from a bong. They like my Purim Shpiel and songs. I write my Purim Shpiel and song. The melody is right, the words are all wrong. It don't matter, they don't last too long. Now with my Purim Shpiel and songs, one more time, I write my Purim Shpiel and songs. The melody is right, the words are all wrong. It don't matter, they don't last too long. I write my Purim Shpiel and songs. Yeah!
And then I write a few lines and I tie the songs together.
Then you find a great cast to make it all work. You made 8 individual performers into a cohesive, well-oiled machine. My fellow cast members, you are all wonderful actors and singers who are in desperate need of a shower. Speaking of showers, has anyone heard the weather report for tonight?
One of the ship's crewmen, Isaac, wanted to turn this Purim cruise into the love boat with me. I dropped anchor. But before I sunk his battleship, he told me they were expecting heavy storms tonight.
You worry too much, Joni. The ship is going to be okay, and you're going to have a whale of a show. Tomorrow, remember, the show starts at 8 p.m. sharp, no matter what. All right, everyone, good night.
Before I read from the Megillah, I would like to invite Julie Meyer to the stage. Tomorrow, Julie will play Queen Esther in our Purim Spiel. Well, tonight, she will explain why there is no mention of Purim in Bing Crosby and Fred Astaire's Holiday Inn. Here's Julie.
Festivals are
Thank you, Julie. And now I will read from the Megillah. I'm about to tell the tale of a major Jewish festival with characters all credible and ethnical and cynical. It starts with King of Shushan and a banquet that is centrical, a marathon that takes 6 months and yet is rather seasonal. Who asks his wife, Queen Vashti, to dance and show her genitals? She turns down his request and soon is banished. How regrettable! In the period that follows, Ahasuerus is again distressed, repressed, undressed. To find himself a wife, he holds a Shushan beauty contest. So Esther enters sensual without the help of cannabis. She is an undercover Jew and wins. It's quite miraculous. These characters are credible and ethnical and cynical in the middle of a tale of a major Jewish festival. And soon the story deviates. God's Biktan and Old Terish plot to kill the king with chopsticks, which is different here than Camelot. But in walks Mordecai with strength and honor of Sir Lancelot. The king dresses the guards in formal suits and ties with hangman's knots. The king decides that Vizier would save him from atrocities and hires Haman for the job. Oh, he's a big monstrosity who orders all to bow. The Jews refuse, not their philosophy. In ancient times, they liked to pick on all of the minorities. Then Haman orders genocide for Jews who will not genuflect. He feels that it's appropriate as payment for their disrespect. These characters are credible and ethical and cynical in the middle of a tale of a major Jewish festival. Ahasuerus fights a case of temporary sleeplessness. He reads his annals about the eunuch guards and all their evilness. He asks his vizier about how to honor one with accolades. He recommended to the king an ostentatious promenade. He ordered such as a reward for ever-present Mordecai, a major Jew whom S. Haman planned to be the first to crucify. In order to stop Haman, Esther plans a gluttonous feeding fest. That's when the revelation is revealed of Esther's Jewishness. Boy, 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 boy. So Ahasuerus changes course and Jews are granted clemency. And the vizier is now the one who's hanging from the highest tree. His characters are credible and ethnical and cynical. It's the ending of the tale of a major Jewish festival. Thank you very much, Armageddon.
Dear cast, because of the storm, we must muster right now in a safe place. Please meet me on deck at the bow, which is the front. Bring an umbrella and wear your life preserver. Well, that sounds reasonable. I'm sure Megillahgan knows what he's doing.
Maybe the show won't go on.
Oh, it looks like I'm all alone here on this island. It looks like I have everything I need to survive here. I see coconut and banana trees.
Hey, I can make daiquiris.
There's a palm tree for shade. I hear a waterfall, which must mean there's fresh water.
Hey, how did this stay dry? It still works.
Ah, better don't have reception. 5G, my butt.
Well,
looks like I'll just have to make myself comfortable and wait until they come back and...
rescue me.
Looks like they tried to kill us Jews again. And we survived. At least I did. Looks like I'm all alone on this island, which looks like it's got everything I need to survive. Coconut and banana trees and a palm tree for shade, and I hear a waterfall. Well, that must mean fresh water. Now, how did this stay dry? And it still works. No service. 5G might took us. I might as well get comfortable and wait for them to come back and rescue me. Say, seeing those two words made me feel a little better, a little stronger. I think that I will sing solo. Part you will remember. I am all alone, blazing in the sunshine on the beach, you know. Without actors, singers, and me, there's no show. I am a schmuck stuck on this island. I obsess with my diet. I just eat veggies and fruit. I can't eat any dairy. Dairy gives me gas. My luncheon, I'll be munching on some grass. I am a schmuck stuck on this island. Don't think of food. I'm just glad I swam ashore. Not sinking in the deep blue sea. I will survive this island. I'm peeling just those scars. I'm better trained and better be a star. I am a schmuck stuck on this island. And I'm a schmuck to complain on this island. I won't die.
Oh my God, I'm gonna die. At least there's food and water on the Isle of Joni, and I'm the only resident. No bars. Keep the faith, Joni. Don't panic. You can do it, as long as crying is it. Wilson? Wilson, where are you, little buddy? Wilson! Oh, thank God. I thought I lost you. You're my best friend. Remember how we met? That's right, on the set of Beach Blanket Bingo with Frankie and Annette. You were great in that movie. We became great friends and we moved in together. You know what I was just thinking? Of course you know what I was thinking. You always know what I was thinking. I was thinking about when we did Hamlet in the park. Let me see. Alas, poor Yorick, I knew him well. Such a terrific guy with an excellent imagination. And now this is him. How terrible. It makes my stomach turn. I know how many times I kissed the lips that used to be right here. Where are your songs now, your pranks, your jokes, your flashes of wit that used to set the whole table laughing? You don't make anybody sing now or laugh now, do you? Are you sad about that? Or are you sad because we're stuck here on a deserted isle with neither shelter nor loo, Shakespearean for bathroom? To pee or not to pee? Where is the restroom?
A signal! A signal! My kingdom for a signal!
No phone, no light, no motor car, not a single luxury. Ah, but I have my Blue Cross card. Let's see. It works on television, but not in reality. Oh, I hope the skipper's out looking for us. I'm sure he'll know we're gone when there's no Spiel tonight. In the meantime, I'll wait.
Hello, is there anyone else on this island? All of the actors and the director get washed overboard and no one lands on the island with me. I call that antisocial distancing. I cannot mask my feelings of loneliness. Why couldn't that gorgeous king get stuck with me? Ah, to heck with the beauty contest. I picked the king for me.
Oh, looks like this little island has everything that I need. But does it have everything that I want? Like a fridge full of bottled water. I may be stuck on this island by myself, but I will survive. I may be stuck on this island, but I have never missed a call time in all my years as an actor. I may be stuck on this island, but damn it, the show will start tonight at 8 p.m. I will do my part at my time, and it will be the best performance of my life! And I know, after hearing McGilligan's speech, the rest of the cast will do the same. Well, except for maybe that blowhard Wilson. We may not have an audience to view our show live, but I know that the universe will record history's first ever multiple island Purim Spiel. The show will go on!
This isn't good. Not only am I all alone on this deserted island, but I tore my dress, and I broke a nail. No, I am going to think positive thoughts, and my problems will be solved. What? Look what just washed up on my beach. It's a trunk. I wonder what's inside. Toilet paper, and it's 2-ply. That's great. I wonder what else is in there. Designer dresses and costumes, and they're in my size. I think I'll try one on. A little much for the afternoon. A little too red carpet. Not quite enough sandy beaches. This is great! It's just like my Esther costume. I know, at 8 p.m., the show will go on.
Well, 1:01, and the sun is forming a spotlight directly on me. I, King Ahasuerus, will start the opening banquet scene of the show in 3, 2, 1, curtain up. I got a big pile of money, I got a blow. We're gonna party with all my dough. I want now to see my wife dance new. Well, you can say that it's true, but I want to see my master dance new. Well, you can drink my beer, vodka and gin. Drink all my wine as much as you can. You can eat everything, there is so much food. But baby, I'm in the mood. I want now to see my wife dance new. Well, you can say that it's crude, but I want to see my master dance new. Well, I can send the guards to fetch the queen. She's got the best bod that you've ever seen. She can sing and cut a rug. So come on, Vashti, and jitterbug. I want now to see my wife dance. Well, you can say that it's true, but I want to see my Vashti dance. Nude, the Vashti nude, yeah! Nude, the queen dance nude. dance. New. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks for bringing me here, Phil and Don. And honey, I know what you want to ask me, and I have an answer for you. Just try not to get all shook up. There's no way I am gonna strip and give in to your ego trip. There's no way I'm gonna dance nude for the world.
It's been 6 months since I vanished, Vashti. Vanished, Vashti. And I'm starting to get a little lonely. I know. Maybe I should have a beauty contest with all the lovely maidens of Shushan. Calling all maidens!
Hi, I'm Joni, your former dental technician and a young maiden from Shushan. I want to be your bride. Because I love you more than Joni loved Chachi. You make me smile. My smile is warmer than the Mona Lisa, happy like a lark. My smile is wider than a Cheshire cat that has a certain spark. My smile is brighter star that makes every night worthwhile, and there is nothing in this world that could ever change my smile. Something happened in my mouth the day that I lost you. This thing doesn't happen every day. You are always on my mind, no matter what I'm
do, and there's nothing that can make it go away. My smile is warmer than the Mona Lisa, happy like a lark. My smile is wider than a Cheshire cat that has a certain spark. My smile is brighter than the brightest star that makes every night worthwhile. And there is nothing in this world that could ever change my smile.
I'm Kelly, a young maiden from Shushan, and I want to be your bride because I love a good time like you. When I hear the sound of good music around, I jump off my chair and start dancing. No matter the style, I will dance for a while, as long as the band keeps on jamming. Whether swing ropes or twerk, you just watch my feet. I can polka without a beer barrel. I salsa or hip-hop, merengue or foxtrot. Will you dance with Miss Kelly Fitzgerald?
Hi, I'm Esther, a young-ish, maiden-ish, girl of Shushan, who knows that I'm your type. I've done the research, and I found out.
A girl like me is what you're after. When you are looking for a spouse, I'm like the Martha Stewart of Shushan. I won't stop cleaning up.
Careful consideration of the hundreds of girls in Shushan, I choose Esther. If Esther can't perform her queenly duties, Kelly shall assume those responsibilities. I now pronounce me man and wife. I may kiss the bride. Esther, come here.
I have had enough of King Ahasuerus to last me a decade. Do you agree? Let me say this. Life is hectic, and I'm a skeptic. With our problems, we get no rest. Denied our sleeping, I'm getting stressed by that big pest. Nonetheless, I hate complaining or hesitating, although morally we must do. Though it's a pity, since he turned 60,
me a beast. Let me tell you my point of view. This must stop. He's an alcoholic. This must stop. He's like Eli Wallach. He's a barking dog or a croaking frog at night. He's a sinus headache, a rooster daybreak, a losing fight. He's a jerk. He's a royal diva. He's the crust on a truck stop pizza. He's a thoughtless king who cannot sing a flop. So then, buddy, no more waiting. This must stop.
Thoughts ironic, I'm not demonic. They align with mine, they're fine. And I can see clearly every sign that it's a deadline for that swine. Jaded eunuchs in flowing tunics have to give it one good try. It's time and season for all those reasons. King Ahasuerus now must die. This must stop. His head needs a banging. This must stop. His neck needs a hanging. With a jagged knife, I will end his life with pain. Do me one big favor, use an ancient saber and end his reign. Well, all right. With a poison snake bite, with no fight, he'll go to the bright light. Then the two former guards will be the ones on top. So, buddy, no more waiting, this will stop. Like nails on a blackboard, he's sauerkraut.
It's the end. He will soon be finished. He'll be gone, just like Popeye's spinach.
Send him to the moon, and then his balloon will pop. Then, buddy, no more waiting.
Buddy, no more waiting.
Then, buddy, no more.
I better tell Esther and King Ahasuerus. Dear King Ahasuerus, and your beautiful new bride, Esther, I know you've been very recently married, and you probably prefer to spend time alone together. So, just listen to me tell you the news about your two unit guards, Big Ten and Teresh. Two guards are planning sin. They want to stop your heart from beating by beating your head so hard that it starts bleeding. They're planning to do you in. I tried not to listen in. I'm not a boy who never stared or been a tattletale. But you had to hear the news flash faster than Castle Mail. They're planning on doing you in. So take my advice, it will save your life. Put the brakes on the plans that I've heard. Tonight you will capture them without a rough fight. Not deceased, not deceased, never fear. Don't let go, Regal King. Be clever and win. This isn't hyperbole. Won't need no apology. You know just what to do so that you won't get screwed for that plot before it kicks in. Yes, they're planning to do you in.
Thank you, Mordechai. I shall have Bigtan and Teresh captured tonight as they sleep, and at dawn, hung from the highest tree in Shushan. Ah, it's good to be king. But I need an assistant king, a man or woman who can help a monarch here in the 5th century BCE. Let me think. I have it. Haman, as an official in my court, I am elevating you to the position of assistant king. Assistant king. That sounds too lame. We need something with a little more flair. Haman, you shall be my vizier, my enforcer and advisor. You may pass any law you care to that keeps Shushan and me safe.
Why, thank you, King. I will address the citizens of Shushan. Good people of Shushan, gather. Tell all your friends to join us here in the castle square. There's plenty of room over there on your left. Don't worry about the fountain, just come to where you can hear and see me. Those of you with the obstructed view by the columns, don't worry, we'll give you a discount. Wow, I can almost see them. 10,000 Shushanians have gathered in mere moments. Quiet, please! The king has just named me his vizier, given me his signet ring, and told me to pass laws that will make for a better kingdom. My first law! That all people shall remain totally quiet while I speak. Doing a good job with that. Okay, just listen and hold your applause to the end. My second law is that all people shall bow down to me. Now let's try that. Okay, very good. What? Doesn't look like those people are bowing down to me. Maybe they all have bad backs. No, they're wearing those long sideburns and yarmulkes and stars of David. They must be Quakers? No, they're Jews, and that Mordechai is one of them. I must tell the king at once and pass a law for Jews only. Equality schmality. King, I have news to report that I've just learned of since becoming your vizier. Good king, hearken to the daily news. Not everyone listens to my laws and my views. So be a sport, just follow my cues. Cain, you gotta help me when I kill Jews. Loony, loony, maybe loony. Loony, maybe loony. Loony, maybe king. You gotta help me when I kill Jews. They're not bowing, seems like they don't follow laws. I'd like to help to rid them of their fatal flaws. They have to go a schluff into a permanent sleep. They're only out to cocker so nobody'll weep. So be a sport and just follow my cues. King, you gotta help me when I kill Jews. Loony, loony, maybe loony. Loony, maybe loony. Loony, maybe king, you gotta help me when I kill Jews. You send in the army and I'll play my guitar. The date will be 2 weeks into the month of Adar. So be a sport and just follow my cues. King, you gotta help me when I kill Jews. Loony, loony, maybe loony. Loony, maybe loony. Loony, maybe king, you gotta help me when I kill Jews. All right. If you agree with the plan, don't say a word. Then it's agreed. We will send in the army on the 14th of Adar to wipe out all the Jews. Your Highness, I take my leave to meet with the generals.
The acoustics behind this tree are marvelous. I overheard Haman telling King Ahasuerus about putting all the Jewish people to death. Well, what they don't know, but a few others than I do, is that Queen Esther is Jewish. And I will tell her about Haman's evil plan, and she will put a stop to that vizier. My dear cousin, you've achieved quite a bit at a very young age. Winning a beauty contest and marrying a king all before turning 18. There's one more task that you have to do if you want to see 21. The wonderkin, I hope has dimmed since I saw the king. With busy A, they planned a day of this I sing. Woman used to kill the Jews, now I told you what they planned. We need a hand from Wonderkin. Your duty calls like matzo balls in chicken soup. Avoid our end, just tell your friend to save our troops. I want to live, so you must give the king the truth about the Jews. And he will choose you, my Wonderkin. Bear in mind, you'll save our kind from evil Haman's scheme. The heroine Samaritan of today's live stream. So now's the time of order, crime, prevent our bitter end. My cousin Anne, my Wonderkin. Oh, the Wonderkin. Yes, my Wonderkin, our Wonderkin.
I know what I must do to save our people. Make meatloaf. I will have a banquet for King Ahasuerus and Haman, and I will serve my world-famous meatloaf. And string beans, and applesauce, and kishke. And I'll have it on the 13th of Adar at 7 p.m. because I get too hungry for dinner at 8. And at 7:45, while they're munching on my par banana pie, I will reveal to them about my being Jewish and Haman's lies. Oh, it'll be quite the floor show. The Copacabana has nothing on the Shushan Palace. Speaking of banquets, I'm getting very hungry. I think I'll pick a banana. Oh, there's one.
Ah, 3 days till Esther's banquet, and 4 days till Haman's anti-Semitic program.
What was that? Pogrom?
Ah, I can't sleep. Maybe I'll read my annals. Oh, annals.
What's this?
Bigtan and Teresh tried to kill me, and Mordechai saved my life?
What would Haman do?
I know.
I shall have Haman give Mordechai a parade throughout Shushan, seated on my finest horse and wearing my noblest attire.
Oh, it's time for my parade. Well, thank you, Haman, for the horse.
Oh, whoa, 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 nice horse, nice horse.
My husband, King Ahasuerus, and Vizier Haman, I hope you both enjoy the meatloaf. And now, since you are enjoying dessert and your mouths are full, I have something very important to tell you. Just listen to this message about Haman.
You must save your love. Time to use your big heart, King.
between us, it does not take a genius to see that Haman's just a bad con. Love was when I met you, and I know you fell too, cause I sound like Celine Dion.
Undo my edict to have the Jews slaughtered, but I can hang Haman from the highest tree in Shushan, and I shall tell the army I will help the Jews defend themselves. When history records the 14th of Adar, the Jews will have survived and created a holiday.
No, we will have a festival, and we will tell the story in a Megillah and in a funny satirical play which we'll call a Purim Shpiel.
We will give baskets of treats to our family and friends, and we'll eat three-sided cookies, which we'll call Hamantaschen. We will eat and drink to excess, and we will tell the story of how Haman tried to kill this Jewish people, but we were saved, and we'll always be saved. Amen. Look! There's a boat coming to take me from this deserted isle! And I am saved! The entire cast is on it, so we're all saved! It looks like we could all use a little rescuing now. Megillahgan was right. This is the best Purim ever!
Oh, out of the costumes, a dozen of to dress up, be silly like the king. Look up a banquet, a reason for a feast, so eat and drink like a year. Yes, we need a Purim Shpiel. Had some rum and tashin, baskets for the neighbors, candy for some notchin. Yes, we need a Purim Shpiel. Had some rum and tashin, the 14th needs to get here quicker, like the king will all get shaker. Shake your Gregor whenever you hear Haman, cause he's really mean. Cheer for Esther, the greatest female hero until Kamala now. Yes, we're glad it's a new season, for a dozen reasons. Thankful for our freedom, knowing that our lives have meaning. That is what we're singing, happiness we're bringing. We need a Purim Shpiel now. Put on the costumes, make sure your makeup's great, and that your hair is straight. Warm up your voices, it's Purim time and for till our Seder plates wow. Yes, we need a Purim Shpiel, and some rum and tashin, baskets for the neighbors, and eat for some notchin. Yes, we need a Purim Shpiel, and some rum and tashin, the 14th needs to get here quicker, like the king will all get shaker. Stretch all your muscles, it's been a whole year since we've been in quarantine. Drink all the vino, you know that wine time helps you laugh a little bit more. For we played a lot of music, made a lot of laughter, did a lot of singing, springing from each actor. Yes, we've been a little silly, does it really matter? We need a little